Lasse Lund here at PAX Prime 2012. We are here on the show floor for theweeklyblend.com. We're talking with Jeff Strain. And remind me of what your development firm is called again.
So we're with Undead Labs.
All right, great. And you guys are showing off State of Decay. What is State of Decay? Just explain the concept. Explain what you're showing here at on the show floor.
So State of Decay is an open world simulation-based zombie survival game. The idea is that rather than kind of scripted events or putting you into kind of just a shooting simulator, we really want to capture the essence of the zombie survival genre. It's not just about what you're doing today, it's about the choices you make today impacting what happens to you tomorrow and next week and next month. So it's a game where you can go anywhere, go into any building, search for resources, rescue other NPCs, invite them into your community, build your base, plant gardens, create infirmaries, basically just upgrade your infrastructure and start trying to rebuild civilization in your own small little way so that you can survive the zombie threat, not just today, but over the next weeks and months as well. We really want a combat to be sweet console action combat, right? Fast, in your face, really bring you into it viscerally. And so the combat, there's a strong focus on melee combat. There's literally hundreds of different types of guns and weapons that you can find in the game. You can create workshops to manufacture your own munitions, Molotov cocktails, all the way up to sophisticated trigger mines. And you use those to go secure buildings, take them over, create an outpost there, and basically push back the zombie threat just a little bit more so that you can keep your supply lines going. So combat's a big part of the game because it helps you protect your base, which is always under attack, and continue your investment in technologies and infrastructure. So one of the real differences of the game is that you is more your community than any one specific character. So you play one character at a time, you start the game with a character, but as you go through the world and rescue other people and do things for them, bail them out of a difficult situation, give them food when they're hungry, you start earning their trust. And after you've earned enough trust, they become your friend. You can invite them into your community. Once they become your friend, you can actually play as that character. So the character you're playing at any given time, if they die, they're dead. It's a permadeath game. That's just what you got to do if you really want to have a survival-based game. But they also get tired. So if you've been playing the same character for 4 or 5 hours, they start getting fatigued. They need to go home and go rest. And so you can go switch to another character, somebody who's fresh, load them up with weapons, look at their specific set of skills and abilities and say, this is going to be appropriate for what I want to do right now, and go out with a fresh character. So really what you're trying to do is build a community of characters that you enjoy playing with. And our core mission is build this game, really pioneer this kind of simulated world, open world zombie survival game. Create a kick-ass single-player game, take a lot of feedback from the player community about what they like, what they don't like, and then use that as a stepping stone to build a full online world game where you and all your friends can play together in the same world. The game is being built for Xbox Live Arcade and PC download, and we're targeting early next year for release.
All right, well, we've been here with Jeff Strain with Undead Labs talking about State of Decay, and you can check out this video and other videos at theweeklyblend.com. Mm-hmm.